Hi, I'm Megan. Today we're going to perform a pulse ox on this dog. This is our pulse ox machine, and what it's actually measuring is the percentage of hemoglobin that is saturated with oxygen. So it can give you an idea of how well your patient is able to deliver oxygen. Animals that are icteric or very, very anemic, you're going to have a difficult time getting a good pulse ox on them. Also, patients with very poor perfusion. We are going to be using the periphery in order to get this pulse ox, and so if they're not perfusing their periphery very well, you're going to have a difficult time. So how this works is this little probe here has a light that shines, and so this light is actually passing through the blood, and that is what it's kind of refracting off of that hemoglobin and oxygen, and that's what's going to give you your number. So you want this to go on an area of very thin skin. So usually the lip, the ear, the toes, sometimes in the inguinal region, you kind of pinch some skin on the flank. On dogs, you can use the prepuce. On female dogs, you can use the vulva as well. All of these places where you're trying to find some mucous membrane or some very thin skin where you can place this probe. So on this dog, I'm gonna try her lip. And you can see she does have some pigment on her lip, but she's got a good pink spot right there. So I'm going to take the probe and place it on her lip. And she's being a very good girl. A lot of dogs try to swallow. They'll try to kind of chew the probe out. So anything you can do to distract them to keep that on there. It's good to give it, you know, a good 10 to 15 seconds to kind of get its bearings and give you a reading. The bottom number here is going to be her pulse rate. And so in order to make sure that this machine is actually reading what it should, I need to know what her pulse is and match it to this number here. And so when I took her pulse, it was right around 60 beats a minute. And so this is reading right around 60. This top number here is the percentage of hemoglobin that's saturated with oxygen. So she is at 97%. For a dog breathing room air, we like it to be anywhere from 95 to 100%. So I'm very happy with that 97%. It's good to kind of leave it on there and let it read for, if you can, 20 or 30 seconds, just to make sure that that number stays, you know, with her between 96 and 98%. So when I record this, I can write either a range, 96 to 98%, or whatever number it stays on the longest. It's also a great idea to write down where I got the pulse ox so the next technician knows that I can get it on the right side of her lip. And then we will perform this as often as needed to check how well our patient is oxygenating. And that is how we get a pulse ox.